Your life is an expression of what you think. And today we're going to learn how to control your thoughts, how to master your mind, therefore live the life that you've been wanting to live. All right, I'm Annette Reeder from thebiblicalnutritionist.com, and it is always my pleasure and joy to serve you God's recipe for excellent health. And today it's all about our thoughts. I've been teaching you that it's just as we're physical, you are spiritual, and just as you're spiritual, you are physical. And did you know that there's one ingredient that flavors both areas, and that's your thoughts. Your thoughts control where you go with yourself physically, how you believe in yourself spiritually. So we have to learn how to control our thoughts. So this is a really important step. This is really step one. If you were to take a 90-day transformation, this is step one. Many people want to alter the foods, alter the exercise, but if you don't change the mindset, the results don't change. They may change temporarily, but not long-term. And who wants to keep doing this over and over and over? Let's change the results long-term. So that's what we're gonna talk about today. And so we're going to talk about powerful words, words that can create a riot or words that can bring righteousness. Which would you rather have? You know, so this is very important for us to understand. So great thoughts today are going to lead to a wonderful, a life transforming, an energizing, a healthy tomorrow. Actually, I'm recording this right now. We're kind of at the end stage of the COVID shutdown and the reopening and all of that. And it's the people who have the least fear who are adapting the best. And that all comes from our thoughts. So let's look at Philippians 4:8. It says, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is of good repute, if there is any excellence or anything worthy of praise, let our mind dwell on these things. Let's think on these things. But sometimes it's difficult. Sometimes it's just difficult. I remember before I did our transformation, I thought I was unworthy, unloving. I was fat. I was depressed. I was ugly. I was just unlovable. I was, you know, I already said I was unworthy. I was stressed. But those were thoughts that I chose to believe. I had to really go in and do a battle with my mind to get it to see myself differently. In fact, in the Treasures of Healthy Living Bible Study, which is a Bible study that I've written that's been taught around the world in churches and in small groups, there's a video series on how to have self-control. And in that video, I share that I literally would get up every morning and say, I hate my body. I don't like the way it looks. I just don't like it. I had to change my thoughts to, I love the body you've given me, meaning God. I love the body you've given me. I had to change my thinking. Now, to even try to go back to those previous words, it just kind of hurts. It doesn't fit. It's like trying to put on, you know, a size 20 jeans when it's like, well, these don't fit me anymore. That's not me anymore. And that's what I also teach in our 40-day course, is that one phrase, that's not me anymore. Okay, so don't go back there. So today we're gonna talk about how to change our thoughts, and then I want you to write that down, that's not me anymore. So when the wrong thought starts to come in, you say, nope, that's not me anymore. So we have a lot to cover today. So I'm just looking through my notes so I don't miss anything. And so Philippians 4:8, you know, those are words that we can meditate on. And today I'm going to share with you five simple steps on how we can change our thoughts and how we can actually master our thoughts, and our life will be an example of that. So let me just ask you, are you ready to be set free from the bondage that your thought life may have been causing? It can cause you to have relationships that are just always in turmoil. It can cause you to have just a mindset that's like, I just don't really like living here anymore. Your thoughts can cause you to be able not to be able to work as well as you should. So what are your thoughts and how do they lead to results? So let's look at the five steps. Step number one is to identify your thoughts. This may sound simple, but one author was saying the majority of your time, your thoughts directly control how you are feeling at any given moment, regardless of whether you're consciously aware of it or not. So there's many times we just have thoughts that we aren't paying attention to. So number one is, I want you to identify your thoughts. So this may be simple, this may be difficult. In one of our previous coaching classes that we had with our 40-day course, one of the ladies was saying, when my grandchildren come over, I always sit on the couch and eat pretzels all day. Well, that what I had to have her do is like, okay, let's take that situation and let's bring it down to just one thought. There was actually like five or six different thoughts going on in that scenario that she painted for us. We had to bring it down to just one thought. And so we brought it down to, when the grandkids come over, I eat pretzels. Okay, the stress of the grandkids coming over causes her to just kind of sit down on the couch, just veg out and eat pretzels all day long. So working through the situation, the grandchildren can't make her eat pretzels. The situation can't make her eat pretzels. It was the thought that made her eat pretzels. And so by taking control of the thought, we were then able to identify the thought and change the thought, because the result was the extra salt was causing her to become bloated, gain extra water weight. It was interfering with her blood pressure. It was causing weight gain, and it was causing her just to feel so much guilt. Well, we don't really want to be living like that. So we went back and traced down the thought, and then we helped her reword the thought. And it has to be something that you do. No one can change this thought for you. You have to reword it and you have to change it. But number one is to identify it. And so when we start the 40-day course, and you can do this anytime, it doesn't require the coaching. When you go through the 40-day course, the first thing is start identifying the thoughts. What are the thoughts or the beliefs that you believe about you? Some people say, well, I'm just fat and ugly. Some people say, well, I'm not a good mom, or I'm not this, or I'm not that. And then write them down. We can't change them until we identify them. And many of our thoughts are kind of in the subconscious or the unconscious level. So we've got to pull them through, write them down, and identify it. And then the second step that I always have people do is ask yourself some questions. I want you to question these thoughts. And here's some questions for you. Where will this thought lead me? So if I think a thought and I let it work through and it leads my hands and feet to do something, where is it going to lead me? Now, if we watch the wrong movies on TV and they're full of, you know, love scenes and, you know, always adultery, almost every love scene on TV is adultery. It's crazy. And so if I'm watching that and it creates a thought in my life, in my mind, where is that going to lead me? Okay. Another question is, are these thoughts scripturally acceptable? Dr. Charles Swindoll did a complete video on this, preaching sermon on this, and this is where I got the thoughts, these questions from him. I had my own, but his were better, so I thought, well, I'll just use his. And so we need to understand this. So where will these thoughts lead me? Will these thoughts get me to where I want to go? Do they agree with scripture? Because there are numerous scriptures that explain that you are the royal priesthood. You have an inheritance. Well, we don't give inheritance to people who are unworthy. We give inheritance to people who are worthy. We give inheritance to people who are our bloodline, to those who have been redeemed. So that's you. If you know Jesus Christ as your Savior, that's you. So we need to ask ourselves, well, Scripture says I'm worthy. Scripture says I am loved. I have loved you with an everlasting love, the scripture says. Scripture says you are the reason he went to the cross for your sins, for mine. That means you've been redeemed. So we don't want to live in regret and guilt when we can live in praise and worship and joy. We're going to get to that. I'm getting ahead of myself. Other questions you can say, will these thoughts build me up or tear me down? Could I share these thoughts with someone else? That's a good one. That tells you, oh, I shouldn't be thinking this. I'll share with you how I handle these thoughts too. Do I feel guilty thinking these thoughts? Do these thoughts fit me as a follower of Jesus? And so in Colossians 3:2, it says, set your mind on the things above, not on the things on the earth. So this is where we are identifying our thoughts, and then we're saying, hey, we need to question these thoughts. First of all, we're writing the thought down. We're not being, critiquing it. We're just writing it down. That's just a huge first step. Identify it. Second is question it. Now we're going to question, is that thought going to help me or hurt me? Is that thought going to be beneficial to my life tomorrow? Tomorrow, am I going to be glad I thought that yesterday? Okay, so think about that. So it talks about in Colossians 3:2, set your mind. Set your mind means to do this continually. It's not like I can set the clock until the time changes in 6 months. No, it means continually, habitually, I am setting my mind on things that are good. So I'm going to have to do this over and over and over again, because the devil's never going to give up trying to feed me the lies that, oh, remember what happened yesterday, or remember what happened 5 years ago, remember what happened 20 years ago when you did this, this, and this, remember what that person did to you 20 years ago. Well, that's this battlefield of the mind that we can overcome. So if you say, I am weak, you're siding with the devil, because that's what he wants you to think. This is why we have to ask ourselves questions. You know, who am I siding with? Am I siding with the enemy, or am I siding with Christ? With the words of Christ in Colossians 3:16, it says, let the words of Christ richly dwell within you. Richly means extravagantly. So the more we are extravagantly dwelling in God's word, the more we're going to be able to answer these questions correctly. And the more we're going to be able to set our mind on things above. And set our mind is a continual process. Dwelling on his words extravagantly, richly, is a continual process. It's not a one and done. Okay, so let's look at number three. Number three is to capture these thoughts, okay, and throw them away. So 2 Corinthians 10:5, they capture every thought and make it obedient. And that's what we need to do. So I've identified it. I've questioned it, and it's like, hey, if it doesn't line up with what's going to bring you success, with what's going to make you your best, then you capture it. It's like snaring it, you know, capturing it in a net or in a snare. And then you know what? You go to the front door of your house and you just throw it out and say, you're not welcome here anymore. That's not me, and I do not agree with it. Now, if it's a thought that brings, you know, honor and blessing, and it's like, yeah, that's me. That's me. And in our 40-day course, we talk about how to give credit. And I've got a podcast coming up on how to give yourself credit. And that helps us build the good thoughts. So we just need to realize and get rid of the weeds, get rid of the wrong thoughts, and that way your flowers can bloom stronger. So capture the thoughts and throw them away. Okay, so we just need to understand that what you do today, you reap tomorrow. What you do today, you reap tomorrow. And habitually seeking is a continual process. So we have to continually do this. So number three, capture your thoughts and throw them away. Satan likes to blind the unbeliever, and he likes to deceive the believer. All right? This is a battlefield. Every one of us is dealing with it. No one has conquered it until we are in heaven. It's a battlefield. Recognize the battle. Recognize who's fighting whom, and then go to war on your thoughts. Now, let me ask you this. So if you're ready for a transformation, are you really ready? Like, hey, you can lose the weight. Yes, you will be beautiful. Yes, you are loved. Yes, you are loving. Yes, you can have everything that Christ has promised you. Understand that if something doesn't fit, throw it away. If that thought doesn't agree with you, or agree with who Christian or who Christ says you are, throw it away. Okay, so let's then control our thoughts. Number four, renew our thoughts. And this is where we come back to these two verses that I've been reading about setting your mind. So I need to renew my thoughts. I need to reword them so that they are in agreement with God's word. I told you my example earlier. I used to think I'm ugly. I don't like the body I have. And then I changed it to, I love the body God's given me. I love the body God's given me. And I had to say that over and over and over and over again for a long time before it fit, before I actually started believing it. And that's important. So renew your thoughts. Set your mind on things above. Set your mind on things above, because every perfect gift comes from above, comes from the Father of light. And that's what we need to be focused on. I know some thoughts are hard. Some thoughts are difficult. And you may say, Annette, you don't know what I'm thinking. I don't, and I don't want to know, but God knows. And he is the author and perfecter of our faith, and he can help us change our thoughts. Remember, our thoughts create our feelings create our actions create our results. What results are you getting with that thought? Take it captive now, throw it out if it doesn't agree with scripture, and start moving forward. And then number five is start rejoicing. In Colossians 3:15, it says, It says, and let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body, and be thankful. This is about the peace that's going to come when you're thinking on these things, when you're dwelling on these things, when you're controlling your thoughts. You're going to have peace. You're going to have love. You're going to have joy. You're going to have praise. You're going to have thanksgiving. You need to understand you can't complain and praise at the same time. It's impossible. You can't do it. So I hope this has helped you. These are just five simple steps. They work. They work today, they work tomorrow, they will always work to help you have the life you were created to have. May God bless you, and be sure and hit the subscribe button and follow us on YouTube and Facebook so we can help keep sharing with you God's recipe for excellent health.